Hello, my name is Laura Ramirez. I am assistant professor at the Delft University of Technology. Welcome to the fourth course in our MicroMaster series, Solar Energy Engineering. This fourth course is called Integration of Photovoltaic Systems in Microgrids. In this course, you will learn about various aspects of AC and DC microgrids. Let me first introduce other lecturers of this course. I will be accompanied by Professor Paul Bauer, head of the group DC Systems, Energy Conversion and Storage, and Dr. Seyyed Mahdi Isatkast, lecturer at our university. Our course on the integration of photovoltaic systems in microgrids is divided into 5 parts. After a short introduction, the first 2 weeks will address the definition, components, and layouts of microgrids. In week 3, we will discuss power electronics interfaces in microgrids. Then in week 4 and 5, we will look into the control, which is seen as the heart of a microgrid. In week 5, we focus on the emerging DC microgrids and discuss the potential benefits that can be obtained from the DC technology. In week 7 and 8, we discuss protection schemes within microgrids and then finish the course with an overview of demonstration sites. Let's now go through all of these 5 sections in a bit more detail. The first 2 weeks are all about definitions, components, and layouts of the microgrids. We may ask ourselves why the topic of microgrids has recently attracted a lot of attention from industry and the academia. The key point to answer this question is that microgrids are seen as the main building blocks of the future sustainable smart grids. In other words, to achieve large-scale grids, we have to properly build them up from the micro level. You will learn about 3 general grid levels, where our focus is on the microgrid level. You will learn about the definition of a microgrid and the different microgrid scales. We will also discuss the main differences between a microgrid and a virtual power plant. You will learn about the advantages and disadvantages and characteristics of the components in microgrids, which can be based on non-renewable sources like diesel or based on renewable energy sources like solar and wind. We also focus on different characteristics of the energy storage technologies, their optimal sizing, and integration of microgrids. We will look into the various layouts of microgrids based on AC, DC, or a combination of both technologies. And we'll compare the performance of several layouts based on the efficiency criteria. In the second part, we'll discuss the power electronics interfaces. We'll discuss all combinations of AC and DC power electronics interfaces. You will learn about the various interfaces in AC and DC microgrids for renewable generation components, non-renewable components, and energy storage components. In the third part of the PV4X course, we will discuss the control aspects of the microgrids. We'll look into the intelligent local controllers and microgrid controllers and discuss the primary, secondary, and tertiary control. You will be introduced to various types of power converters, and we will discuss the implementation of the frequency and voltage loop controllers. You will also learn about the communication schemes at different levels and the relevant standard for microgrids. We'll wrap up the third part with the centralized versus decentralized control in microgrids. We'll discuss the stability in the presence of distributed generators and their potential impact on the power quality and the continuity of electricity supply from the microgrids. To ensure this continuity, we discuss the islanding and black start processes for microgrids. We finish this part with the ancillary services, demand response, and potential business models for microgrids. In the fourth section of this course, we'll particularly focus on the DC microgrids. We will discuss the DC technology and compare the DC electronic transformer with its AC counterpart. You will also learn about the DC standards and applications in real life. We will also discuss in detail the single and multiple DC buses for monopolar, homopolar, and bipolar topologies to which photovoltaic systems are connected. In the final section of the course, we will look into protection examples and demonstration sites for microgrids. You will learn about the protection in microgrids, including the electronically interfaced distributed generators or the induction electrical machines that typically have very different fault currents. We will provide a good overview of the various available protection methods, We'll introduce fault current sources and current limiters in different locations in a microgrid. Then, we'll analyze these faults outside of the microgrid at the upstream network and compare them to the faults inside the microgrid, introducing adaptive control schemes. Finally, you will learn about the existing operational AC and DC demonstration sites around the world for off-grid and many other applications. Now the assessment. Following most of the video lectures, you will find exercises to apply your new gained knowledge. These exercises are meant to test and improve your understanding of the concepts discussed in the videos. So try these exercises and don't be afraid to make a mistake. All the weekly exercises combined count for 15% towards your final grade. The practice exam counts towards 5% of your final grade, and it is meant for the students to practice and get familiar with the format of the proctored exam. The proctored exam is only available to ID verified students and counts for 80% towards your final grade. You can qualify for the PV4X verified certificate by achieving a minimum final score of 65%. New in this course are the microgrid control assignments. In these assignments, you will be able to play with the different components, control, and protection methods in a microgrid. The microgrids are built in Simulink, which is a MATLAB plugin. As a result of the support we received from MathWorks, a free license to MATLAB Online, including Simulink and Simscape, is available for PV4X students. The microgrid control assignments are graded as regular assignments and will greatly help to better understand and visualize the interaction that occurs in microgrids. Besides the regular content, PV4X also features a live webinar, in which you can interact live with the course team. The webinar generally includes a behind-the-scenes tour at the TU Delft, an interview with the titan of the industry, and an interactive discussion in which the course team treats the issues introduced by the students. Look for more information in the webinar tab of the introduction and extras section. The ID-verified students will have access to the exciting challenges. The challenges are topical issues where the course team interacts with the ID verified students. Each challenge will receive a feedback video. You can find the challenges in the introduction and extra section of the course. All the information provided in this video can be found in the course syllabus. On behalf of the entire DC Systems Energy Conversion and Storage team here at the Delft University of Technology, I'm very excited to provide this course for you. I hope you are ready to jump right in and become an expert on the varied landscape of microgrids.